villain Deepatsy. Let's learn about her life and experiences. Catherine Deepatsy was born into a noble family in Florence in 1556. The normal course would have been for her to have married into wealth and enjoyed comfort. But Catherine chose her own path. At age 9, she learned to meditate from the family confessor. She made her first communion at the early age of 10 and made her vow of virginity 1 month later. At 16, Catherine entered the Carmelite convent in Florence because she could receive communion daily there. Catherine had taken the name Mary Magdalene and had been a novice for a year when she became critically ill. Death seemed near, so her superiors let her profession her vows in a private ceremony from the court in the chapel. Immediately after, Mary Magdalene fell into an ecstasy that lasted for about 2 hours. This repeated after her communion for the following 40 mornings. The extraordinary was ordinary for this saint. She could read the thoughts of others and predict the future events. During her lifetime, Mary Magdalene appeared to several people in the distant places and cured a number of sick people. She was plunged into a state of darkness where she could see nothing but what was horrible in herself and around her. She had violent temptations and endured great physical suffering. Mary Magdalene Deepatsy died in 1607 at the age of 41 and was canonized in 1669. So friends, what does the life of Mary Magdalene Deepatsy teach us? Mary Magdalene Deepatsy is not a saint because she received ecstasies and graces from God. She is a saint because her response to those gifts, a lifelong struggle to show love and gratitude to God who had given her those graces. Mary Magdalene's life is a contradiction of our instinctive thought that joy only comes from avoiding suffering. What her experiences and prayer had given her was a familiar personal relationship with Jesus. At all times throughout her life, Mary Magdalene persevered in prayer and penance in gratitude to God and always seeking His will. Let us pray together to this saint. Saint Mary Magdalene Deepatsy, pray that we will make a commitment to seek the presence of God in prayer the way you did. Guide us to see the graces of God as gifts, not rewards, and respond with gratitude and humility, not pride and selfishness. Amen.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Peter,
pray for us.
Saint